my cancer piece. As a 46-year-old woman, married to a man for 25 years, we have 4 children, and I just knew everything was just perfect. You see, I thought I did everything that was supposed to be done. But then I found myself doing a movie with Robin Williams called Bicentennial Man. And for some reason, the director looked at me and said, "You, come out of the line. I need you to change your clothes." And as they began to change my clothes, they lifted up my shirt. And because I'm a stickler about my body, I grabbed my breast and I felt the love. But I wanted to do a movie. So I continued. And if you get a chance, I dare you to go look at that Bicentennial movie. You see me in there with my blonde and black hair. It had started falling out due to chemo, so we kind of glued it in there. But they never knew. You know, I pondered over this day, like, what is National Cancer Survivors Day? Really? Nobody ever gave me a party. No one ever really celebrated in my family. So I come in memory of my mother, Georgia Swanson, battled with cancer and lost. My iconic cancer. My Aunt Ruth, a warrior who took on trials for tamoxifen, who gave her body to the Cancer Society so that I may live. My niece, Tanika, who lost her life because she was afraid to fight. Now I could go on and on that I had it in 1999. But then I had a dream, and God had told me it was back. I said, "Are you kidding me? I thought you loved me, God." And he said, "It's not for you. Somebody got to know that I'm still a healer. Somebody got to know. grateful to those women and men who helped me with chemo. Because I'm going to tell you the truth, I could be a nightmare. Oh, yeah. I am the one that would say, I like you, you hurt me. Because I was afraid. But I can tell you today, because of Kenny and Maggie, who gave this cute suit, but come in and say it's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. So with that, I found my favorite, favorite poet that I met when I was 11 years old passed away this week. And I have been a poet since I was 11. And I had come to the point where, I'm going to be real with you, I said, God, if you want me to be a poet, why must I suffer? And he told me I didn't suffer. That was just part of the journey. So I heard Maya say, Sandra, take my poem and still I rise and put a little flavor on. No, for real. I heard Maya say, don't forget about me. She's walked and talked with me. I've seen magazines in the office that got me through an appointment with Maya Angelou. So, you know, that's my girl. And you know what I'm saying? And we just kind of rocked it out at the San Francisco Opera House as she proceeded to do a poem. And so I hope I do justice for you all, because I prayed and I fasted and I prayed and I asked God, what can I give those cancer survivors? So if you are a cancer survivor, raise your hand just so I'm, hallelujah. Thank you, God. I just had to see for myself that I'm not the only walking miracle. So let us change, and still I rise, and still we rise. You may write us down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may tread us in the very dirt, but still, like dust, cancer survivors, we will rise. Does our sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Because somehow we seem to walk in anybody's living room. You see, just like the moons and like the suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hopes springing high, cancer survivors rise. Oh, I'm sorry. Some of you wanted to see us broken. Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling like teardrops, weakened by cancer cries. Does our haughtiness offend you? Don't take it off a heart. See, we fight and we don't care, because we're in our own backyard. You may diagnose me with your words. You may cut me with your tools. Some may even say you can kill me with your hatefulness. But cancer survivors rule. Does my sexiness upset you? And does it come as a surprise that this cancer survivor can dance like diamonds in the meeting of her thighs? Out of the huts of cancer pain, we rise. From a disease that tried to make us insane, we rise. We are cancer survivors, coping and wide, welling and swelling, you survivors brought in the tide. Leaving that night before of fear, we rise and look forward into the sun that is clear, bringing the gifts that the physician gives. We are the hope and the dream to live to live. God bless, God encourage you, and may you be all that you were created to be. Thank you.
That one more, and you've already been wild.